It is, this is, I'm gonna do a 2 minute job. Maybe three or four, it depends. This is one of my old favorite songs. So let me see if I can. So, and it's April the 29th, 2024. My job is April the 29th, 2024. It's about 8 p.m. So Elon Musk, let me see, Elon Musk or Elon. I'm at formerly extended stay, now I'm a suite. Imagine, okay, black Negro males and females using the science through this the technology of the United States military and police to stalk you. The buck, he don't behave no ways, no different than what you say you have been, you were African American studying plantation slavery. And you come across black males that have that same, and females that have the same energy and personality of that which was written about during so-called plantation time. The buck and the black female. Okay? The buck is so much like an animal, it cannot restrain itself. The female is so much like an animal, it can't restrain herself in reference to violence, rape, molestation. And imagine a government taking it to a step further, using these bucks that are abnormal, unnatural, some type of transhuman, definitely humanoid AI, in lab experiments to steal money and other criminal activities among the black community. And then they got the pale skin that say Mason and three, and the blacks that say Mason and three. And you got the illegal immigrants from South Central America, Mexico, saying Mason and three. And then other illegal immigrants or immigrants or whatever. Imagine, Elon, that they have been collaborating in a system of criminal activity with the help of the United States military, Navy, and Army police for a long time. The Moors come and move to the area where they have been involved in sex trafficking, money laundering, rape, coercion, molestation, any violence, extreme violence, to subdue anyone they feel like is a threat to their system. So during the plantation time, or the so-called plantation time, they wrote in books how the pale-skinned male, the overseer, I think it was a pale-skinned male or the slaver, would teach a buck, I think he was an overseer, to whip and penetrate any black male or female that seemed to get out of line, any so-called slave. So the first thing they would do is rape. They wanted to degrade them, to bring them down. That was one of the first acts of weaponry, rape. Because if they can take away their crown of essence of who they were, of a human being, of a divinity, then they can bring it down to their beast level and really use the slave. So what testimony have I given here in reference to my dreams being manipulated? Predominantly black and Negro males, African-American female accents and feedback in the room, manipulating my dream, rape or molestation. And then hearing blacks on the physical plane, male and female, saying she needs to come down, she too high. And then after a while, imagine, Elon, they start using illegal immigrants from Mexico, South Central America. Because now this is all in connection to the United States Navy and Army and the police to implement more violence. Because the Moors are in their so-called territory, it's not theirs, but their so-called territory where they have a system of theft and criminal activities, whether it's disease, infection, whatever, for a long time. And so those Moors being there messes up everything.
the Black Negro book and the Black Negro female that's been used to create books, they're not able to walk like they're somebody anymore because the Moors are there demonstrating truth about what's going on. So instead of the Moors coming down, the beast, the animal, through the spirit of truth, is being uncovered. So the fancy car, the money, the question is, how did it really come about, even if they graduated from school in some form of college? What did they do? So I'm not saying African-American blacks. I'm saying imagine. That is an example. Okay? Because I've been given testimony about the telepathic code before you demonstrated that it existed, Elon. And so to know that Annapolis still have what they call a slave port, as far as I know to this day, where they claim Alex Haley's descendants are from Annapolis, where his descendants are from Gambia, West Africa. They claim that that is a slave port. And they claim, and some Moors said when Alex Haley descendants were looking for, that means someone that was connected to that line was looking for information about Alex Haley. Alex Haley is an author that created, some Moors say he didn't do it, that it was fraudulent. But there was a movie called Roots, and it was about slavery. But nonetheless, they said that in Annapolis, when they were searching for his information, they went to the circuit courts, and these are family members of him that were searching their history, and they couldn't find anything about him in the human circuit court. They had put the descendant of Alex Haley with the beast and animals, the cattle. The descendants or the connection with him listed as beast, cattle, some form of an animal. Now, that is really interesting. I'm not saying he is or the descendant is, but now what have I been giving testimony about? Black, Negro, I'm like, what is wrong with these blacks? Not all in Annapolis, but too many. What's wrong with them? Why they want brother? She love your son. They gonna rape her. He effed her. He effed you. These are beast and animal thoughts.